God calls Samuel, based on 1 Samuel chapters 1 through 3, chapter 4 verses 1 through 11, and chapter 6 and 7.
In the hundreds of years since the Israelites settled in the promised land of Canaan, they often turned from God to worship heathen idols. As a result, their priests have become corrupt, and they are dominated by their enemies, the Philistines. The priests no longer serve God's people with merciful hearts. At the Lord's house in Shiloh, Eli, the high priest, watches the faithful come to worship. He notices a woman, and suddenly he becomes angry.
Her lips are moving, but she's not saying anything. Another drunk who needs to lay off the wine.
Angrily, he accuses her.
No, I'm not drunk. I'm unhappy. In my sorrow, I poured out my heart to God, asking him to help me.
I am sorry for my hasty judgment. Go in peace, Hannah, and may God grant you what you've prayed for.
Oh, Lord Almighty, if you will have pity on my misery and give me a son, I will dedicate him to you for all his days.
God does answer Hannah's prayer. When her little boy Samuel is old enough, she brings him to Eli.
God bless you, Hannah. I will teach your son to be a servant of the Lord.
Samuel stays with Eli and eagerly learns how to serve God. Each year when Hannah and her husband come to worship, she brings Samuel a new coat.
It's just like a priest's robe. Thank you, Mother.
Eli is proud of Samuel. As Samuel works in the temple, he shows his devotion to God, unlike Eli's two sons, who sin against God and cheat the people, even though they're priests. One night, Samuel hears a voice.
Samuel.
Samuel rushes to find out what Eli wants, but Eli hadn't called him. He goes back to bed. Again, a voice calls him.
Samuel.
Samuel goes running to Eli's room again. Eventually, Eli realizes that God is speaking to Samuel. He instructs Samuel to answer the Lord and listen to whatever message God has for him. The next morning, Eli asks Samuel what God has told him. Samuel doesn't want to repeat the message, but Eli insists.
God said, Eli's sons are wicked, and Eli has not tried to stop them. They will be punished for the evil they have done.
It is true. He is the Lord, and he will do what he knows is right.
Word spreads that God has spoken to Samuel. As Samuel grows up, all of Israel knows that he is a true prophet of God.
If only our priests were men of God like Samuel, how long must we suffer under the lying and cheating of Eli's sons?
Mark my words, they will bring about their own destruction.
The people of Israel are losing battles against the Philistines. Even though it is forbidden, Eli's sons take the Ark of the Covenant from the Lord's house and bring it to the battlefield. The Philistines kill Eli's sons and capture the Ark. Eli falls and dies of a broken neck when he hears that the Ark has been captured. The Philistines suffer many plagues while they have the Ark in their country. The Philistines return the Ark of the Covenant to Israel, but now Israel is worshiping idols. The Ark is taken to a house where it is forgotten for many years. Young Samuel grows up to be a godly man. After years of struggle under the Philistines, the Israelites are finally ready to listen when Samuel speaks.
Return to the Lord, worship him with all your hearts, and God will deliver you from the Philistines.
Samuel is right. Let's throw away our idols and worship God.
Let's all go to the city of Mizpah, where we can repent and pray together.
Eagerly, the people follow this man who speaks boldly for God. By the thousands, they set out. But the Philistines discover the great march to Mizpah.
If thousands of Israelites are massing at Mizpah, it can mean only one thing. They plan to attack us. We'll strike before they do. And this time we'll crush them so badly they'll never fight again.
Meantime, at Mizpah, the Israelites assemble before an altar to God.
Forgive your people, Lord, and help them. They have torn down the idols and repented for turning away from you.
Suddenly, a loud shout rings through the camp.
Help! The Philistines are coming!
Ask God to save us, Samuel, or we will all be killed.
The Philistine army prepares for a rush attack on the Israelites at Mizpah. On the hilltop, Samuel offers a sacrifice and prays for God's help.
This time, we'll teach them a lesson they won't forget.
But when the Philistines are within battle range, a sudden storm breaks.
We can fight the Israelites, but we can't fight the God of thunder and lightning!
God has answered our prayer!
Let's go after them!
The Philistine defeat is a turning point in Israel's history. Never again, while Samuel is Israel's leader, do the Philistines invade Israel. As a reminder of God's help, Samuel puts up a stone monument. He calls it Ebenezer, which means stone of help.